Senator Pia Cayetano has asked the UAAP Board to reconsider a controversial rule that requires UAAP high school athletes to sit out for 2 years if they want to transfer to a different school for college. TJ Manotok reports.
Weeks after a new UAAP rule hit the news and social media, former UAAP volleyball player and now triathlete, Senator Pia Cayetano, called for a hearing with her Committee on Youth and Sports. The new rule in question, the UAAP is requiring a UAAP high school student athlete to sit out 2 years from competition if he or she moves to a different UAAP school for college. The UAAP defended the rule, saying it will help schools protect their investments in their high school athletes.
More on the time spent in molding the athlete. For some schools, I think they send them abroad for training.
Cayetano has not kept it secret that she feels the rule is unfair and possibly infringes on rights.
The Constitution requires that we protect our youth, that we encourage their development, and that sports is a big part of it. I do know that you lose valuable time when you sit out playing years, and I cannot say that this is for the best interest of the student if these are the practices that we will be implementing.
Resource persons invited to the hearing are also against the rule. The Council for the Welfare of Children says it virtually denies a student athlete of a free decision for his or her personal academic and sports development. Sports psychologists add top-notch athletes may lose momentum and motivation if they don't compete for 2 years. Things also turned emotional when parents expressed their concerns. Jerry Pingoy Sr., the father of FAU Fern basketball star Jerry Pingoy Jr., he feels it's unfair to punish his son, who only wants to pursue his dream to play for Ateneo.
Ang pangarap talaga ng anak ko is gusto siya maging Ateneo. Dahil si Cristio ang ano niya, yung idol. Baliktarin natin, anak nila. Ganonin, ako ang board. Masaya kaya sila.
USD High School champion swimmer Mikey Bartolome, whose dream college is UP, will also suffer the same fate as Pingoy. Worse, she cannot get an athletic scholarship until she makes the UAAP squad in her third year.
Ang sa akin kasi is UAAP is supposed to be educator sila, di ba? Especially yung mga board. So, siyempre, number one dyan is to send the kids to the best school. Na choice ng kids, di ba? So, since na ganun ang pangyayari, pag binigyan mo kasi ng 2 years residency ang bata, alam mo, yung 17 and 18 years old, yan yung mga batang pwede mo to train for the national, di ba? Yan yung bata ng mga peak na pwede sila, mabilis silang matuto. So, malaking bagay talaga para sa mga bata.
The UAAP now says its board will meet on April 16, and anything is still possible.
I'll have to relay all of this to the other board members and see if we can repeal.
It's possible.
Yeah, it is possible because from 1 year we made it 2 years. Yeah. So we can always amend.
If the rule is not changed, this coming UAAP season 76, all incoming college freshmen from a different UAAP high school will have to sit out from UAAP competition regardless of sport. TJ Manotok, ABS-CBN News.
So how was it? Did they have to vote on this, Boyet?
The UAAP board has already voted. And apart from two schools voting to not approve it, the rest have voted to get that particular rule in effect already, supposedly by the start of the incoming season.
Yeah.
Incoming season.
So who voted against it?
The ones who voted against it, if my memory serves me right, are UP and Ateneo.
And both schools are going to be affected immediately because they have student athletes coming from different schools, right?
Mm-hmm. Correct. But more than that, my read on this is because of the immense reactions on social media regarding this. Not only because of one, the athletic aspect, but the educational aspect wherein I'm a student. I went to a school for, say, for high school, for elementary, because that's the only place I can afford. And now I have the opportunity, because of my athletic ability, to go to a better school, because they have a scholarship program that will allow me to play and educate myself at the same time. Mm-hmm. Now, why will you deprive that?
So you're taking that away from them.
You're taking that away from them.
But on the flip side, you have to look at it also the way Ron was saying, you know, the kind of investment the school brings in for that, that's one thing. So if there's anything good about this, obviously it protects the school.
It protects the school.
But definitely for me, it doesn't protect the student at all, because sitting it out for 2 years, for me, is really just unfair.
Yeah.
And it's quite crazy.
It's going to affect your game.
That's a long time. 2 years is a long time. Your
development as an athlete, your career, and your education.
Yeah, I think it was one year in the beginning, right?
Before it was one year residency rule, and then you can already play. But more than that, you know, you used the word investment as far as the scholastic institution is concerned. For a student athlete, it's also an investment.
Right,
because I will invest my time, my energies, my mental state, my family, my social life for some.
Pinky and I were talking about it a while ago. If you look at it from an industry or a business's point of view, an employee which you trained for how many years is going to transfer to another company. It affects what that investment of the company is.
Mm-hmm.
But ito may mga kontrata to for companies. What the board is trying to do here is somehow
treat them like employees.
We don't have a contract with us, we'll just extend the residency
rule.
It sends a
very bad message to the young people. At that age, you're already inculcating in their minds that, pare, pera-pera lang yan eh. Money will be the root of your progress or your decline.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if you give your best to us, then you reap the benefits, whether it be good for you morally or bad for the rest of them who actually want to get your service but cannot, because I have a hold on you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So basically, they want to level out the playing field with
for schools,
mm-hmm. and kind of hinder the students to make their decision by going to maybe bigger schools or whatever. But I think the burden of keeping your student athletes going from a high school to your college should lie on the school. They should take up the responsibility to hopefully build a stronger sports program.
I'll push this question to the three of you. Why is it always the higher marketable schools that are the choice, the more glamorous institutions that usually are the first choice of the student population coming out from high school?
Well, you can say that these schools are more developed. Well, mm-hmm. they okay, lagyan na natin dun mas may pera sila, but they have more funds. They could offer better opportunities and better education than other schools.
And
hindi ko kinukumpara, hindi ko sinasabing mas pangit yung mga eskwela. They could be offering more than just funding.
The perceptive is that if you finish or graduate from these institutions, your chances after school are better.
Yes.
Now, why is it so?
Marketability.
Mm-hmm. So now, for me, it's not a question of how an institution gets the best players, but how they market the institution, how they improve the facilities of their institution so that more students will not say, hindi lang pala yung tatlong eskwela na yan na maganda. Lahat pala kayo magaling.
Well, I mean, I think you can take example from some of the March Madness schools. I know the March Madness is going on.
Look at
that. There are some schools, I mean, Gonzaga University, I want to say like 10 years ago when I was in college, was such a sweet Cinderella school.
Mm-hmm.
And now they're just voted the number one school in the NCAA. As far as basketball, as far as NCAA Division I basketball. So take note from that. You're able to improve certain programs.
You know, at the end of the day,
people want to go there.
Yeah, at the end of the day, they should not equate success in athletics as being success for whatever praises or platitudes for the institution should be taken in. But more than that, guarantee the educational quality of each and every student that goes into your institution and mold them to be, one, God-fearing, two, great citizens of this country, and mold them to be better people.
I think that the officials of UAAP should just be fair about it. I mean, you know, a school, sports doesn't... sports is not the only thing that makes a school good. You know, it's not just... Sports is just a part of the school that makes it, you know, especially UAAP, a volleyball, basketball, etc., right? But I think you should be fair to yourself. Of course, we understand that you need to protect yourselves, but you also have to think about the welfare of the athlete himself. 2 years, for me, Pierre, it's just plain and simple. It's too long a time for anybody to just sit it out and wait till that person goes to that particular school that he or she wants to go to.